Sokoto, with its rich and colorful history, has continued to lead the way in northern Nigeria as the most orderly and peaceful city. Sokoto is located in the extreme northwest of Nigeria. As the seat of the old caliphate, Sokoto is home to the Sultan, who is regarded as the spiritual leader of many Nigerian Muslims.
You have to remember what Sokoto stands for. It is a seat of the caliphate, an empire that once extends to part of Cameroon, Ghana, and Niger. An empire which was built on fairness and equity.
Alhaji Ali Uwamako has been the governor of Sokoto State for the past 6 years. Now on his second tenure, he introduced the policy of integration with various tribes and visitors to the state so as to promote peaceful coexistence, stability, and most especially, security of lives and property.
Sokoto is one place in Nigeria where every Nigerian can go and live freely and whatever he or she wants to establish a business, legal business, freely without any attempt to make him feel inferior or not welcome or some other feeling of that nature.
There are nothing like non-indigenous Sokoto. We have been enjoying the Sokoto as an indigenous or Sokoto. And the same thing with my children, them are also indigenous of Sokoto.
From the inception of this administration that I'm now heading, what I did is say, okay, in Sokoto State, there's no longer non-indigenous. Anybody from anywhere in Nigeria is an indigenous of Sokoto State and should from today not pay any kobo as a school fees from primary to higher level. This was from the time we came in, we tried to make every community living in Sokoto State to have a sense of belonging, to feel loved and respected, to feel welcome and to be allowed to do his or her own whatever she decided or he or she decided for herself freely and with due adequate protection and mature respect.
Sokoto is a destination for most investors in the agricultural sector and other fields because of the friendly group of people and advantageous fenlands in the belt stretching through parts of Zamfara and Kebbi states along the River Rima.
When we are using those days, you take fresh milk, you take the butter, you take the cheese, all locally readily available. All these have gone, you know. So we are trying to restore that type of system that will meet the needs of the people. So he has done that, and we are working. It's important about 500 pregnant cows improved from Argentina. They will be delivered here in addition to the technology that will be used to transform our local breeds. For rice, we are working with the Brazilian farm. They came, they approached us, and His Excellency has invited them. We have signed MOU with them. They are going to set up 2,000 hectare irrigation farms in each of the central zones. Integrated system producing rice, wheat, producing livestock, also fish and other commodities. So we are working on that. We are also working with the Geneva-based Novell Management. They are working on a project for 25,000 hectares. They too have signed the MOU, they are working. His Excellency also went to Turkey. He saw the Turkish feat in agriculture. How much agriculture has been practiced in Turkey. Almost every day, every hour, you see anywhere he goes in the field. So he very much admires what was the display of agricultural achievement of Turkey. So he invited experts from Turkey. And this Turkish firm came and they have been working for the last 1 year to do the design, undertake all the surveys, prepare all the work documents, take up a project between Sokoto and Kebbi.
Sokoto is less than an hour flight from Nigeria's capital city, Abuja, and about an hour drive to Argungu, the town of the internationally famed fishing and cultural festival in Kebbi State. Sokoto has the Giginya three-star hotel, the Pinnacle, the Phoenix, and the Shukura Hotel.
Sokoto boasts of several hotels of international repute, such as this one, the Shukura Coral Hotel, managed by the Lebanese Hospitality Group, the Coral Group of Hotels.
What he did was to invite reputable international hotel managers to come and invest here. They have done it. If you go to Shukra Hotel, if you go to Kigen Hotel, you will see that these hotels are now of international standard. They are now five-star hotels. Therefore, question of accommodation is not, especially hotel accommodation, is not a problem in the state.
Similarly, the governor has built beautiful guest houses around the presidential villa and opposite the government house with adequate security to attract high-profile visitors and investors to the state. Several other projects initiated by the governor have been commissioned by distinguished dignitaries from all over Nigeria. Sokoto Urban Development Authority has been provided with refuse vans and other equipment to ensure that the Asian city is kept clean, as new layouts have been created and provided with beautiful roads and pavement. Sokoto now has a flyover on the busy Gusau Road roundabout to ease traffic at rush hour, a development that stands out in northwestern Nigeria. The Wamako administration has tried to encourage local businesses and businessmen with various incentives such as loans, land, and relevant equipment.
We had a mission to empower our traders, our businessmen. So we went extra mile to provide them with 2 billion naira interest-free loan to be paid in 2 years. We have make sure that we mediate with banks to give them some soft loans to enhance their businesses.
The administration initiated a youth empowerment program with emphasis on skill acquisition. This program has helped to curb youth unemployment and restiveness.
The issues on youth empowerment was self-reliance and as a weapon for fighting other vices from our youth. I also tried to raise issues bordering on healthcare delivery, especially on our rural brothers and sisters who may not have required facilities to attend to their needs in their areas of abode. So along the way, I've tried to make sure that, yes, these areas and many others are taken one by one, prioritized, and addressed based on our perceived requirement, based on our action plan, based on our outcome of our blueprint, and to some extent, I must say, alhamdulillah, we're able to achieve much of what we set as a target.
For potential investors seeking opportunities in Sokoto, the governor pledges several goodies, such as favorable government policies and protection of investments.
If you can see physically, we're the most secure place in the entire country. Peaceful and peace-loving. To the extent that we do provide free land for all our potential investors, we also partner with them when they do require our partnership. And thank God, our businessmen have now grown up to be able to reach out to invite their friends, both within and outside Nigeria, to come talk to and invest. And as a government, we guarantee their security. We guarantee a free and attractive atmosphere for business. We make sure that whoever wants to partner with us as a government, yes, we want to partner with them to do business in Sokoto. We make sure that as a government, we provide all the required atmosphere for peaceful business transactions.
Governor Wamako has continued to support the people with qualitative educational programs as well as dependable healthcare delivery system.
When I first came in, teachers' morale was very low. School environment, with regards, is not attractive for teaching and learning. Pupils and students are not given the right attention they require to be educated or trained. So I try to address the student needs by first and foremost addressing by removing all the obstacles in terms of school peace, which is a problem to the parents across the entire state and across the board, regardless of religious, ethnic, and other various. It was made free from university, from primary, up to secondary, up to school level, and to a extent, up to university level.
Are they teaching you very well?
Yes.
Oh, that's very lovely. Thank you. Bye bye. Come on down.
I try to reintroduce and double all the feeding allowances to ensure quality food and feeding that our parents don't have to battle when their children are going back to school to buy all kinds of food items for the children to carry back to school when they're going back to school. We try to make sure that in the school there are beds and bedding. That all the student needs, you don't have to carry anything from home to school when you're going back to school. Then we also try to make the schools themselves attractive by getting them, by giving them a good rehabilitation facelift, by getting them equipped in terms of furniture and teaching facilities, including good libraries, good laboratories. We try to ensure that, yes, teachers get all the entitlement as anyone do. We try to make sure that teachers are trained and retrained from time to time to ensure to make them more effective as teachers. We try to address some of the accommodation needed. Like most teachers, leading and government recruiters are living free. They don't pay any people that matter. I bought initially 30,000 motorcycles and give them to teachers on loan. The cost of 48,000 naira for a unit instead of the 70-80 naira, which is normally the market price. I also make the supervision in our schools more effective by putting the right people in that place, by giving them the support to report, and their report are being studied by government and act on it. In tune was my pledge to run a government with a listening ear, a government that has respect for the yearnings and the feelings of the government. I try to make sure that all the report I receive from various inspectors and divisions of the state are studied by the ministries and other stakeholders, condensed and sent to me, also to the Executive Council for consideration. And in most cases, we make sure that all those silent issues raised were respected, were addressed. That when we came in, going to NECO, or JAM, state indigenous do that register are not just below 4,000. But by today, we have about 20,000 students, up to 25,000 registered. I can assure you that by now, in most institutions in Nigeria, we're able to fill our quota, which wasn't the case before we came in. We try to, first and foremost, a vision, which we did. So we try to ensure that we address the sector in a very aggressive way to ensure that, yes, the impact is felt across length and breadth of the entire state. By way of, one, equipping all our health institutions with some of the most up-to-date modern equipment required for effective service delivery. We try to ensure the training of our health personnel and the retraining to make them face the challenge of the modern day healthcare requirement in both urban and rural areas. We try to extend the provision of the health facilities to every nook and corner of the state. Such as, for example, when we have already have a general hospital in each of the local government areas in the state, and also in some many cases, some two or three more primary health care centers. We have over the last 1.5 years put across the state 230 type B primary health care centers with 20 bed capacity. And just today, as we are coming, we have finished the recruitment of 1,700 health personnel to go among all those primary health type B health centers across the entire state. Above all, there's a project which is called General Hospital, named after late Murtala Mahathir here in Sokoto. That project was began in 1991 by the regime of General Salih Magashi. But the hospital couldn't be completed until this during our tenure. It was a 500-bed hospital here in Sokoto along Gaji Road. Because the former one, the former one we have here is right inside the town, and it's no longer, the buildings are so old and lifted, and we need a new place to put a new structure in line with the modern day requirements. No one in this state is without a health institution to cut up with their health. We have also been operating a pre-medical care for children under age 5 and also pregnant women. We have been giving pre-medical health care to accident victims across our state. We have since taken over the medical attention of the elderly for 70 years and above. And we have introduced what we call Ramacare, or Rural Health Care Program, in which we bought 30 comprehensive mobile clinics, trucks, which are being used to visit individual communities in their locations, and given some of the basic health assistance or support they require. Simple, pregnant women, diabetic patient, high blood pressure, simple hernia pressure. So many of those such simple, normal ailments were being addressed in various communities where people reside. And it's being done free of charge. We are treating even our kidney victims free of charge in Sokoto State. We have entered in agreement with a medical outfit based in Kaduna. We are already in the state, going local by local government, publicizing their presence, and doing a number of operations to people across the entire state free of charge. As I'm talking to you now, I have people, health personnel being trained across the globe, in America, in the UK, in Malaysia, in Dubai, in Egypt, in Sudan, and even in Nigeria. Our intention is to make sure that, yes, we have enough qualified and competent health personnel to address our health care requirements and needs. We have numerous eye specialists serving free of charge across the entire state. And above all, we have embarked and are still embarking on a massive enlightenment campaign to make people aware of the need to report earlier on matters that affect their health. We try to emphasize preventive rather than curative approach to medical health care delivery. And thank God, the result is so encouraging that we always thank God that we're able to achieve what we've been able to achieve in this and many other sectors.
For the investor and visitor to Sokoto, the slogan, Say Alu, which echoes in the nooks and crannies of the state, simply reassures that the governor, as a man of the people, is appreciated and trusted.
This Wamuko administration has been able to do good things. We have got a lot of employment for our youth. There's a lot of achievement. Our hospital, our schools have been renovated. I think it has done much.
My name is Hajia Aisha Muhammad. I'm indigenous of Sokoto State from Southern Borneo local government. And facts about Dr. Ali Magatikada Wamoko, the governor of Sokoto State, His Excellency, he has brought a lot of development to Sokoto State, especially between the Muslim and Christian communities. He makes sure that they stay in peace and harmony.
I've been in Sokoto for over 40 years. If you consider, for instance, first event with now, there are more development now. And unemployment has been reduced, honestly. And education sector has been improved. Healthcare services, almost every local government has been improved. Well, honestly, we have nothing to cry about now. President administration has taken over all these things now. There's no cause for alarm, honestly.
My impression is that the business is moving, because in terms of business, the business is improving much better than we expected.
My name is David Priestley. I'm 13 years in Sokoto and 33 years in Nigeria. I has done quite well. The roads have certainly improved, which is my particular field. Bridges, drainage, NEPA certainly improved. And construction throughout the state has certainly shown a vast improvement during the expenditure. NEPA is much better, or PHCN as we should call it now. Water certainly improved. And from what I hear from my friends, the education level and health has also vastly improved since he came into power. He also seems an extremely friendly gentleman. I've met him on two or three occasions and have had no problems with him whatsoever.